Hello, everybody. It's Mr. Pomel, and I'm upside down. Why am I upside down? This is really weird and kind of awkward. Hold on. Let me get right side up. Hold on. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. And right side up. Why were you upside down, Mr. Pomel? That was a little bit weird. Well, because it has to do with our book. Let's see how smart you are, because I think you're a pretty smart, intelligent, and amazing group of kids. So let's see if you can figure out. I'm talking about an animal. What animal hangs upside down like that? Animal that hangs upside down. I'll give you another hint. It's kind of like a bird, but it's definitely not a bird because there's no feathers. No feathers at all. Not a totally different type of animal, but kind of like a bird because it flies. Hangs upside down, flies, kind of like a bird, but definitely not. No bird at all, like no feathers or anything. What animal could that be? I'll give you one more hint. And this is a picture hint. What animal looks like that? Anybody know what kind of animal that is? It's flying, but it's not a bird. Do you know? Okay, on the count of three, tell me what it is. Are you ready? One, two, three. What is it? Good job! Yes, it is a bat. Hopefully you said bat. I think you said bat. I'm going to go with you said bat because we're good. Bat is the correct answer. Bat. It's a type of animal, hangs upside down, flies, but not like a bird. No feathers. Well, we're going to learn some other cool stuff about it too, because the book that we're going to read today is a great one. I think you're going to like it. I really like it too. It's called Stellaluna by Janell Cannon. Stellaluna. That's a very pretty name. And I'll give you a little secret. Name of the bat is Stellaluna. She's the main character in this book. Luna. Do you know what that means? Luna means moon. So it has to do about something with night. We're going to have to wait and see. So let's get reading Stellaluna. Let's see what happens to Stellaluna in the book. In a warm and sultry forest, far, far away, there once lived a mother fruit bat and her new baby. Oh, how mother bat loved her soft, tiny baby. "I'll name you Stellaluna," she crooned. Each night, Mother Bat would carry Stellaluna clutched to her breast as she flew out to search for food. Gotta find yummy food to eat. And you know what? It's that picture I just showed you, but if you look closely, look at that. Stellaluna, can you see? Because Mama Bat is holding her right there as they're flying, because you gotta be careful. You know, young bat don't wanna fall. One night, as Mother Bat followed the heavy scent of ripe fruit. Ooh, I love like a ripe fruit. Yummy. An owl spied her. That means saw. On silent wings, the powerful bird swooped down upon the bats. Dodging and shrieking, Mother Bat tried to escape. But the owl struck again and again, knocking Stellaluna into the air. Her baby wings were as limp and useless as wet paper. Oh no, she's too young to fly. Down, down she went, faster and faster, into the forest below. Oh no, this is not a good start to the book. I hope this book ends better than this. There they are. You can see the owl there. And look at Stellaluna falling. Oh. Let's see what happens. The dark, leafy tangle of branches caught Stellaluna as she fell. One twig was small enough for Stellaluna's tiny feet. Wrapping her wings about her, she clutched the thin branch, trembling with cold and fear.
Oh, Mother,
Stellaluna squeaked.
Where are you?
By daybreak, the baby bat could hold on no longer. Down, down again, she dropped. Well, there she is. Look at that. Stellaluna grabbing onto that tree branch there. Upside down, because that's how bats hang. Flump! Stellaluna landed headfirst into a soft, downy nest, startling the three baby birds who lived there. Stellaluna quickly clambered from the nest and hung out of sight below it. She listened to the babble of the three birds.
What was that?
Cried Flap.
I don't know, but it's hanging by its feet,
chirped Flitter.
Shh, here comes Mama, hissed Pip.
I like those names. Flap, Flitter, and Pip. Those are fun bird names. Well, there they are. Look at that. They're like wondering, what was that that just fell into our nest? Because it was something that was flying, but didn't look like a bird.
Many, many times that day, Mama Bird flew away, always returning with food for her babies. Stellaluna was terribly hungry, but not for the crawly things that Mama Bird brought.
You know, little birds like kind of bugs and stuff, but a fruit bat kind of likes fruit.
Finally, though, the little bat could not bear it any longer. She climbed into the nest, closed her eyes, and opened her mouth.
Pop!
In dropped a big green grasshopper.
Doesn't sound yummy to me. But you know what? Stellaluna was so hungry, it was better than nothing. Look at that. Closed her eyes and just tried.
You know, I've never eaten a grasshopper. But if I did eat a grasshopper, know what I'd probably need? Something to kind of wash it down, get that grasshopper taste out of my mouth. No, it would be perfect.
Quick check.
Washed away that grasshopper taste. Much better. If Stellaluna only had some quick check. Well, Stellaluna learned to be like the birds. She stayed awake all day and slept at night. Just kind of like people. She ate bugs even though they tasted awful. Her bat ways were quickly disappearing. Except for one thing. Stellaluna still liked to sleep hanging by her feet.
Because that's how bats normally sleep, upside down. It's true, they do.
Once, when Mama was away, the curious baby birds decided to try it too. When Mama Bird came home, she saw 8 tiny feet gripping the edge of the nest because they were all hanging upside down.
Eek! She cried. Get back up here this instant! You're going to fall and break your necks!
Look at that.
There's Stellaluna in the middle, and the birds trying to hang upside down too. Birds don't normally do that, but they're trying to be like Stellaluna. Look, there's Mama Bird. Oh, Mama Bird dropped her worm there because she was so nervous. The birds clamored back into the nest, but Mama Bird stopped Stellaluna.
You are teaching my children to do bad things. I will not let you back into this nest unless you promise to obey all the rules of this house.
Well, you don't want the birds to get hurt, so I guess I kind of understand.
Well, Stellaluna promised. She ate bugs without making faces. She slept in the nest at night, and she didn't hang by her feet. Stellaluna behaved as a good bird should. Look at that. Mama Bird was kind of a little upset there, but Stellaluna, grateful to have a nice group of friends to hang out with, and Mama Bird is bringing her food, so she's going to try to do her best.
All the babies grew quickly. Soon, the nest became pretty crowded.
Mama Bird told them it was time to learn to fly. One by one, Pip, Flitter, Flap, and Stellaluna jumped from the nest. Their wings worked!
I'm just like them, thought Stellaluna. I can fly too!
Look at that, because they were all flying. Birds can fly. Bats can also fly. And there they are. Look at that, trying to give their first try at flying there. And looks like Pip's flying pretty good. I see Stellaluna there flying pretty good. Actually, they're all trying pretty good. Pip, Flitter, and Flap landed gracefully on a branch. Stellaluna tried to do the same. Uh-oh, what's going to happen to Stellaluna? Well, there they are, you can see. They're landing right on that branch, looking pretty good, pretty cozy, looking the way birds normally look. But Stellaluna, uh-oh, Stellaluna, what's going to happen to her?
How embarrassing.
Stellaluna's pretty awkward there, trying to land on that branch. Look at that. She's upside down there. She's trying to grab back on, and that one there, trying to grab, trying to pull herself up. And let's see, this one over here. Look at that. That's kind of awkward. She's going to fall. And then up this one over here. Up. Kind of awkward there. But trying to do her best job.
I will fly all day, Stellaluna told herself. Then no one will see how clumsy I am.
She's going to try. Look at that. Oh, she looks so happy there. She's practicing. She says, you know what? I'm going to do it. I'm going to be like one of those birds. I'm going to make it happen.
The next day, Pip, Flitter, Flap, and Stellaluna went flying far from their home. They flew for hours, exercising their new wings.
The sun is setting, warned Flitter.
We better go home or we will get lost in the dark, said Flap.
But Stellaluna had flown far ahead and was nowhere to be seen. The three anxious birds had to go home without her.
Oh no, what's going to happen? Look at that. The three birds are there, and Stellaluna's flying so far ahead, didn't even realize they were on their way home.
All alone, Stellaluna flew and flew until her wings ached.
Ugh, that was a lot of flying.
And she dropped into a tree.
I promised not to hang by my feet, Stellaluna sighed. So she hung by her thumbs.
That kind of sounds a little awkward. But she did, and she soon fell asleep.
She didn't hear the soft sound of wings coming near.
I wonder who was approaching. There she is, trying to hang like a bird, you know, right side up, not upside down, but does kind of look a little uncomfortable. Oh, I see those wings there. Something's flying towards her. I wonder what it is.
Hey, said a loud voice. Why are you hanging upside down?
Stellaluna's eyes opened wide. She saw a most peculiar face.
I'm not upside down. You are, Stellaluna said.
Ah, but you're a bat. Bats hang by their feet. You are hanging by your thumbs, so that makes you upside down.
It's kind of awkward. I'll go back to regular way. Anyway, where was I? Let's see. Ah,
you are hanging upside down, the creature said. I am a bat. I am hanging by my feet. That makes me right side up.
Stellaluna was kind of confused.
But Mama Bird told me I was upside down. She said I was wrong.
Wrong for a bird, maybe, but not for a bat. Because bats are different than birds.
And look at that. Two bats are talking there. There's Stellaluna hanging by her thumbs there. And there's the other bat upside down, but the kind of correct way for a bat. So I guess he's kind of right side up and she's upside down. But her upside down is right side up that's upside down. And his upside down is right side up that's up. I'm confused. But that's how bats are.
More bats gathered around to see the strange young bat who behaved like a bird. Stellaluna told them her story.
You ate bugs? Stuttered one. You slept at night? Gasped another.
How very strange, they all murmured.
Wait, let me look at this child.
A bat pushed through the crowd.
An owl attacked you? She asked. Sniffing Stellaluna's fur, she whispered,
You are Stellaluna. You're my baby. It's Stellaluna's mother. Oh, look at that. Look how happy all the bats there are hanging, and she's so happy to find Stellaluna again. You escaped the owl, cried Stellaluna. You survived?
Yes, said Mother Bat as she wrapped her wings around Stellaluna.
Come with me, and I'll show you where to find the most delicious fruit.
You'll never have to eat another bug as long as you live. Look at that. Oh, reunited. Look at that. It's like a bat hug there. Mm. Fruit does sound yummier than bugs, though.
But it's nighttime, Stellaluna squeaked. We can't fly in the dark or we'll crash into trees.
We're bats, said Mother Bat.
We can see in the darkness. Come with us.
Stellaluna was afraid, but she let go of the tree and dropped into the deep blue sky.
Stellaluna could see. She felt as though rays of light shone from her eyes. She was able to see everything in her path. Look at that. How amazing. Because if you look at the picture here, look at that. It's like rays of light. Because bats, you know, they normally fly at night. They see really good at night. You know, if you've ever, you know, if you're in the light, you know, a bright place, and then you turn the lights off, you can't see very good. But after a while, your eyes can kind of adjust and you see better. I guess that's kind of the way that bats must see all the time. They can see really good when it's really dark out.
Wow, pretty cool. Stellaluna didn't even know she could do that. Soon, the bats found a mango tree. Ooh, mango. And Stellaluna ate as much of the fruit as she could hold. Look at this picture. Oh, chowing down on that mango. That looks really, really yummy. Ooh, love it. Stellaluna's probably thinking this is way better than bugs. Ooh.
I'll never eat another bug as long as I live, cheered Stellaluna as she stuffed herself full. I must tell Pip, Flitter, and Flap.
The next day, Stellaluna went to visit the birds.
Come with me and meet my bat family, she said.
Okay, let's go, said Pip.
They hang by their feet, and they would fly at night, and they eat the best food in the world, Stellaluna explained to the birds on the way.
As the birds flew among the bats, Flap said,
I feel upside down here.
So the birds hung by their feet.
Wait until dark, Stellaluna said excitedly. We will fly at night.
Look at that. The birds are hanging with all the bats there. They're hanging out, but they're hanging upside down, too, trying to be like the bats.
Look at that. Stellaluna was a bat trying to be like a bird, and now the birds are trying to be like bats.
When night came, Stellaluna flew away. Pip, Flitter, and Flap leapt from the tree to follow her.
I can't see a thing, yelled Pip.
Neither can I, howled Flitter.
Eee!
Shrieked Flap.
They're going to crash, gasped Stellaluna. I must rescue them.
Stellaluna swooped about, grabbing her friends in the air. She lifted them to a tree, and the birds grasped onto a branch. Stellaluna hung from the limb above them.
That made me a little bit nervous there. Look at that. They can't see like Stellaluna can. Birds really can't see as good at night.
At night, birds kind of sleep in their nest.
So there Stellaluna is. She kind of grabbed them so they didn't fall, didn't get hurt.
We're safe, said Stellaluna, and then she sighed.
I wish you could see in the dark, too.
We wish you could land on your feet, Flitter replied.
Pip and Flap nodded. They perched in silence for a long time.
How can we be so different and feel so much alike, mused Flitter.
And how can we feel so different and be so much alike, wondered Pip.
I think this is quite a mystery, Flip chirped.
I agree, said Stellaluna, but we're friends, and that's a fact.
Wow, even though they are kind of different, similar in certain ways, but very different in other ways,
they're still able to be friends. And that's the most important thing. Look at this picture. I love this picture. Look at that. Stellaluna and all of her friends there. Giving them a big hug there. They're all like hugging each other. Stellaluna's upside down. The birds are right side up. But they're all happy. And that is the end. There's actually some information here about bats. I'm not going to read all of this, but it says, of the nearly 4,000 species of animals on Earth, almost one quarter are bats. That's a lot of bats, a lot of different kinds of bats. How about that? But bats, kind of similar to birds because they can fly, but very different because they fly at night. They hang upside down. They don't have feathers. They have fur and kind of look a lot different. If you've ever actually been out at night, you can kind of see birds fly like during the day and they kind of fly very smooth, very gentle. But then sometimes at night, the other night I was outside and I saw something flying and it was kind of flying like all over the place and kind of like a not as smooth, kind of a crazy pattern. That's a bat because they fly differently than birds fly. But they're good. They're important. They help us, you know. In this book, they eat fruit, but some bats eat, you know, bugs and stuff too. So that can help things too. Anyway, that was Stellaluna. What a great book. Such a good message. Stellaluna there, looking kind of awkward on that branch, but she found her three bird friends. Well, I hope you enjoyed that one. I don't know if I'm going to read another book upside down because that kind of gave me a little bit of a dizzy spell there. But anyway, that was Stellaluna. Hopefully you enjoyed it. That's it for today. Until next time, next episode, and another great book. I can't wait. It's going to be pretty amazing. Until then, see you later, everybody. Goodbye.